I welcome you all in this sixth session of April Student Studies. I am Nisha Abdul Singh Rawat from Class 7, Dhuri International School, Dehradun. So friends, today we are going to discuss about the United States Navy, the Navy which is the largest in the world and that rules the oceans. And we look at the naval might of the United States Navy and its fleet. So friends, let's kick off with the topic. So friends, let's take a quick overview of the United States Navy. The U.S. Navy is the naval warfare branch of the United States Armed Forces. It is the most powerful navy in the world with the 290 active surface combatants. And it also has the second largest air force after the United States Air Force, with more than 3,700 operational aircraft. It has 3,36,978 active duty personnel, and the Chief of Naval Operations of the United States Navy is Mr. Michael M. Gilday. This is Mr. Michael M. Gilday, the Chief of Naval Operations of the United States Navy. So friends, now look at the fleet of the U.S. Navy. The fleet of the U.S. Navy comprises of the Nimitz-class supercarrier 10 in service, Gerald R. Ford-class supercarrier 1 in service, Wasp-class amphibious assault ships 8 in service, America-class amphibious assault ships 2 in service, Blue Ridge-class amphibious command ships 2 in service, San Antonio-class amphibious transport docks 11 in service, Los Angeles-class nuclear attack submarines 32 in service, St. Wolf-class nuclear attack submarines 3 in service, Virginia-class nuclear attack submarines 19 in service, Ohio-class nuclear ballistic missile submarines 14 in service, Ohio-class nuclear cruise missile submarines 4 in service, and Ticonderoga-class guided missile cruisers 22 in service, Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyers 68 in service, and the Zamora-class stealth guided missile destroyers 2 in service. And the Independence-class littoral combat ships 11 in service, and the Freedom-class littoral combat ships 9 in service. So friends, now take a detailed view of the United States Navy. So the first one to rule the seas is the Nimitz-class aircraft carriers. These are 10 class of 10 supercarriers produced for the United States Navy. It displaces more than 1 lakh tons, and each aircraft carrier carries 6,000 servicemen and up to 90 fixed-wing aircrafts. And this is powered by 2 mighty nuclear reactors. And these are also considered as the main fighting wagons of the United States Navy. And the carrier class comprises of the USS Nimitz, USS Dwight D. Eisenhower, USS Carl Vinson, USS Theodore Roosevelt, USS Abraham Lincoln, USS George Washington, USS John C. Stiles, USS Harry S. Truman, USS Ronald Reagan, and USS George Washington. They are the backbone of United States carrier fleet. And now comes the advance in the most modern aircraft carriers and warships in the world, the Gerald R. Ford class aircraft carriers. Each of this aircraft carrier displaces about 1 lakh tons, and it is powered by 2 nuclear reactors and can carry up to plus 75 aircraft, more than 75 aircraft, and it doesn't have catapults. It launches aircraft by magnetic power. While the older Nimitz class aircraft carriers have been powered by catapults, they use catapults to launch their aircraft. And among the Gerald R. Ford class aircraft carriers, one in service, that is the USS Gerald R. Ford that is pictured here. And the USS John F. Kennedy is ready, and it is in fitting out status. And the USS Enterprise has been laid down, and USS Doris Miller is under construction. So friends, now look at the Wasp class LHDs. The interesting fact about these LHDs are they are even bigger than some aircraft carriers of other navies. Each of this amphibious assault ships or landing helicopter dock weighs up to 40,000 tons and carry up to 40 helicopters or VTOL aircrafts. They can deploy up to 20 Sea Harriers or F-35 Lightning Thunders. The Wasp class is 8 in service. Wasp class LHDs are 8 in service with USS Wasp, USS Essex, USS Kear Sergey, USS Boxer, USS Bataan, USS Bonhomme Richard, USS Iwo Jima, and USS Macon Island. So friends, let's move on. Now comes the America class LHA, landing helicopter assault. The America class LHDs are developed from the Voss class LHDs and are even heavier and displace about 45,000 tons and can deploy up to 40 aircrafts. And there are two in service, USS America and USS Tripoli, and USS Bougainville is under construction. And this is USS America pictured here. And now comes the Blue Ridge class amphibious command ships. These are the control centers, like floating control centers of the Navy, and all the Doppler radar systems and the radar systems mounted on it helps to transmit messages and signals. And the Blue Ridge class two in service. Blue Ridge class amphibious command ships are two in service with the United States Navy, that are the USS Mount Whitney and USS Blue Ridge. Now comes the San Antonio class amphibious transport docks. These are the newly and the highly advanced LPDs constructed for the United States Navy, and these are 11 in service with USS San Antonio, USS New Orleans, USS Mesa Verde, USS Green Bay, USS New York, USS San Diego, USS Anchorage, USS Arlington, USS Somerset, USS John P. Matra, and USS Portland, USS Fort Lauderdale, and USS Richard M. McCool Jr. It is USS Fort Lauderdale. And the interesting fact about the USS New York is the remains and the steel from the World Trade Centers was used in making the USS New York. The steel obtained from the World Trade Centers that was destroyed during the 9/11 attacks in the United States in New York. The steel was used to make the USS New York. So friends, let's move on. The Los Angeles class nuclear attack submarines, they are the backbone of the United States submarine fleet, and these are 33 in service. These massive submarines are 33 in service, Los Angeles class. And the Sea Wolf class nuclear attack submarines, these are also known as the F-22 Raptors of the seas, as it is very difficult to trap them underwater. The Sea Wolf class attack submarines are three in service with USS Sea Wolf, USS Connecticut, and USS Jimmy Carter. The interesting fact about Jimmy Carter is the normal Sea Wolf displaces about 8,000 tons, while the Jimmy Carter displaces over 12,000 tons. So now the Virginia class nuclear attack submarines, they are the newly constructed nuclear attack submarines. The Virginia class nuclear attack submarines are 19 in service with the United States Navy. And the interesting fact about the United States Navy is it operates all nuclear powered submarines and nuclear powered aircraft carriers. Now comes the Ohio class nuclear ballistic missile submarines. They are the part of the nuclear deterrence of the United States and also the backbone of the nuclear deterrence. The Ohio class ballistic missile submarines were constructed 18. But 14 are in service, with 4 converted into cruise missile submarines due to the reduction in nuclear treaty. The nuclear reduction treaty, these were reduced to 14, and the other 4 were converted into cruise missile submarines. And among the Ohio class ballistic missile submarines is USS Henry M. Jackson, USS Alabama, USS Alaska, USS Nevada, USS Tennessee, USS Pennsylvania, USS West Virginia, USS Kentucky, USS Maryland, USS Nebraska, USS Rhode Island, USS Maine, USS Wyoming, and USS Louisiana. And now comes the Ohio class nuclear cruise missile submarines. They have been converted into cruise missile submarines due to nuclear reduction treaty. And these are in 4 in service with USS Ohio, USS Michigan, USS Florida, and USS Georgia. And now comes the Ticonderoga class missile cruisers. The Ticonderoga class missile cruisers are 22 in service with the United States, and these were the first ships to equip with Aegis combat system, the modern system developed by the Lockheed Martin, the technology master of the United States, the Lockheed Martin. They were constructed 27, but due to several problems in their systems and they were getting old day by day. Out of the 27, 5 were retired and 22 are still in service. The Arleigh Burke class guided missile destroyers. These are the backbone of the United States Navy. Arleigh Burke class guided missile destroyers are 68 in service with the United States Navy, and more, and 82 are planned, and several are under construction. And these will become the United States Navy's backbone. And the United States Navy states that this mighty destroyers will last. The first that were created during the 1990s were last till 2045, and the others who have been recently constructed will last till 2080s. Now comes the Zamor class stealth guided missile destroyers. Their appearance is very odd appearance. They have a very odd appearance, but they are deadly and lethal weapons of the United States Navy. They are completely stealth, and its radar cross section is about a fishing boat floating in the ocean. If anyone sees it on the radar, it will appear like a fishing boat, and this can mislead and can result in lethal consequences. This Zamor class guided missile stealth destroyer displays about 14,500 tons. Like a cruiser, they are cruisers, but they have been considered as destroyers due to political reasons. The USS Zamor, USS Michael Mansour, and USS Lyndon B. Johnson. These are the three Zamors that have been constructed. They were first planned 30, but they were reduced to 3 because of lack of funds, and these are, we can say, the monsters of the seas. Now comes the Independence class littoral combat ships. The Independence class littoral combat ships are 11 service. These also have a very odd appearance. They have a trimaran hull, and they are similar to corvettes in other navies. The Freedom class littoral combat ships. Now comes the Freedom class littoral combat ships. They are 9 in service, and they have also the characteristics like corvettes of other navies. Now comes the main thing that we have to discuss in this video, that is the Aegis combat system developed by the United States tech giant, the Lockheed Martin. The Aegis combat system is a combat system developed by American defense technology giant Lockheed Martin. It was developed for forces to defend mainly carriers and their battle groups from ballistic missile or air attacks. These are air defense systems developed by the Lockheed Martin, and they are equipped on warships to protect the United States Navy's aircraft carriers. The most powerful thing that they had is they are equipped with Mark 41 vertical launching systems for ballistic missile defense. They are equipped with RIM-161 missile, SM-3, Standard Missile 3, and RIM-156, Standard Missile 2, RIM-174, and AN-SPY-1 radar. The Royal Australian Navy, the JMSDF, United States Navy, Republic of Korea Navy, Spanish Navy, and Royal Norwegian Navy use this Aegis combat system. It includes Phalanx CIWS, close-in weapon system. And the Titan Deroga class guided missile cruisers were the first to be equipped with the Aegis combat system. Now this is the missile defense agency that uses Aegis ballistic missile defense for the cruisers and the warships of United States Navy. This is the emblem of Missile Defense Agency. Now we will discuss about the Aegis combat systems. This is the image of a Titan Deroga class cruiser. And the main thing that you can identify Aegis combat system is the octagonal radars on these ships. Like this one here, an octagonal radar. You can easily see an octagonal radar on these ships. Like here, and these ships are equipped with Aegis combat system. The ships we had that had octagonal radar systems, AN-SPY-1, this is known as AN-SPY-1 radar systems. And these octagonal radars are the main, they give the idea that they are equipped with Aegis combat systems. Now come the components of Aegis combat system. This is the Mark 41 missile launcher vertical launching system, and this is a Phalanx CIWS. It is one of the most lethal weapons equipped on the ship. These are automated and not to be controlled by humans. They choose their targets on their own and smash them with bullets. Now the ships that use Aegis combat system in the United States Navy, almost all their warships use Ace Combat System except littoral combat ships and the aircraft carriers. And this is the Ticonderoga class cruisers and the Ali group, USS Winston A. Churchill, shown here. And this is the USS Port Royal here, and they all use Aegis Combat System. You can easily see the octagonal radar here on two sides of this destroyer. So these are the United States ships that uses Aegis Combat System. And other navies, the Hobart class destroyers of the Australian Navy, also Royal Australian Navy also uses Aegis Combat System. You can easily see the octagonal radar here, and it is also the opposite side, the octagonal radar systems. And now the Alvaro de Bazán class frigates of the Spanish Navy also use Aegis Combat System, and the Hobart class destroyers of the Australian Navy have been developed from these frigates. And you can easily see the octagonal radar here and octagonal radar there, that side. And now comes the Japanese. Japanese also use the Aegis Combat System. The Maya class destroyers, the Atago class destroyers, and the Congo class destroyers. These all are equipped with Aegis Combat System. You can easily see the octagonal radar here at Congo, here at Atago, and here at Maya. So friends, let's move on. And South Korean Navy also use, Republic of Korea Navy, the also uses the Aegis Combat System. You can easily see on this destroyer, the Sejong, the Great Class Destroyer of the Republic of Korea Navy, this octagonal radar here. And these are also considered as the most lethal destroyers in the world. And now friends, the Norwegian Navy also uses Aegis Combat System with easily visible octagonal radars on these ships with octagonal radars, and it is also equipped with Aegis Combat Systems, and they are also considered as the most lethal frigates on the planet. Now comes the Chinese. The Chinese have a habit of copying each other's and having of copying others, and the Chinese Navy has developed a system that can compete with the Aegis Combat System. Like you can see here on Type 52 D class destroyers of the Chinese Navy, PLAN. These are not octagonal, these are squarish. Squarish radar system, which are similar to Aegis, but the octagonal radars is the main point that can prove that it is equipped with Aegis Combat System. So friends, I hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel APS Studies. Thank you.